Mock people, me again. And today we have McCallan. Oh, such great expectations. My goodness, Ralph, you're really rough. You're spoiling yourself today, aren't you? Here we go. McCallan, that beautifully rich caramel-enhanced colour, that elegant broad-shouldered bottle, the little house at the top of the label, which is so famous, apparently, and McCallan, the name McCallan, associated with the finest single malt that Scotland can produce. Extravagant prices at auction and on the open market for old, rare bottlings of the McCallan. 50-year-old bottlings, 40-year-old bottlings, going for thousands of pounds. Such is the reputation of McCallan, which frankly, at this moment in time, isn't really justified. I'll come to that shortly. So here it is. Let's review this whiskey. Amber plus 3, it's pretty dark. Certainly sherry influenced. I don't think there's that much caramel in it, to be honest, but there's nothing to say on the bottle that there isn't. Very much a style bottle rather than a artisan bottle. And I think that's one of the problems here, that you've got this great, great whiskey, but it's being presented as an ordinary brand. Not like Springbank, where they present it as an artisan whiskey. Let's move on. Dark malt nose is good, very sherried, sweet Oloroso sherry, but there's various sherries going on there. Raisin, allspice, dried fruit, nutmeg, cinnamon in the background, and a certain presence of treacle toffee, although I'd say it's a fairly kind of dry treacle toffee. Taste-wise, and I'll just add a wee drop to this. Naturally, I'm speeding this up for the sake of a video presentation, so if you're doing this at home, slow it right down, take your time. Pour yourself your malt and then have a wee glass of blended whiskey while the malt's opening up. There's older whiskies than 10 year old in that. I think there's some going on 14. That's a good sign. You can feel there's a sense of age there. Age in whiskey and also in casks being used. There's a sweetness, sherry toffee, marmalade. Yeah, good know that, the marmalade. Vanilla, rich vanilla, almost kind of baked vanilla. Honey, muscovado honey, old spice. But there's something... there's something odd happening at the end of the arrival as you go into the development and conclusion in the palate here. There's something slightly hard and metallic, and I can't put my finger on it. There's a dryness, a crispness, but it goes beyond that and becomes quite aluminium. It's something I've mentioned before in a whiskey. Odd. The whiskey is, considering its reputation, considering the quality of the stills, the quality of the casks, the fact that McCallan actually own sherry sources and are particularly good at using different oak woods out there, as demonstrated in their fine oak range, I can only say that I'm being left a bit disappointed with this. It's good whiskey, but it's not excellent whiskey, and it should be excellent whiskey. Oh, just get a wee bit of E150 at the end there. 82 out of 100. Yeah, okay, well, hopefully things will improve. Ralphie.com. If you need to know, you know where to find it. See you soon.